Welcome and thanks for joining me in this video. Krita 4.3 has been released with a lot of things that you can already use and enjoy. My name is Ramon Miranda and in this video I'm going to review some of these features that maybe need a bit of explanation. Are you ready? Let's go! Krita has spent more than a year fully focused on improving Krita's stability and performance. And believe me when I say that making a good software is a real challenge. It's like when you eat a cake, you only see the beautiful look, but you don't know how much effort it takes to produce it. You can read more carefully the release notes if you want here in this link. And if you want to skip directly to the feature you want to see, use the timecodes. They are available in the description below. We will talk about the invisible part, so please don't miss that part at the end of the video. And this is an overview of what we are going to cover in this video. Android. Saraf Zaman is working hard for Krita in Android. This means we could be using Krita in the tablet with Android. How cool can be something like that? Imagine Krita on Samsung Tab X6 or Note 10. It would be really interesting to test it. And Krita has coders working on that already. Anime Dosunova, for example, is adding Samsung's art actions, as you can see in her Twitter account. Animation. Emets and Eoin O'Neill are working really hard to provide better animation tools with less bugs and more optimized. We can now export only one frame when we select the rendering dialog and mark that options. Resources, watercolor. We all know Krita has powerful brush engines, and watercolor is the hardest simulation that digital media can afford. So I decided to contribute a bit given my knowledge to provide more watercolor brushes by default. I will talk about them in a future video, explaining how to get the best of them and how to create your own watercolor brushes. But now let me show you some of them and give some hints on how to use them better. Okay, so here we go with some hints to use all these watercolor brushes. So as you can see, we have a lot of different brushes and we can get lost. But if we want to test only the watercolor, we can use the search box and right where I see, you can see all the new brushes are filtered with this text. These brushes are ready to be selected and just paint. They don't need to change anything, just left as the creamy mode because they were redesigned completely from scratch to be usable with the default Krita mode. Go here, so configure Krita, and I change the cursor shape to always at least have a small circle, which is the center of my brush, and the outline shape, I use the circle outline, because now I see only a line and it's less annoying, at least for me. So you can see all the default brushes. It's perfect to create a cumulative effect. Also to create a bit of texture, like a dried brush stroke. And this is special to create the wet edges effect and even drops with a bit of careful. Also, we can use this brush to get a nice effect and subtractive mode. We can create interesting things. Also, we have this, which is more grainy effect. And remember, these were created with the default resources. This one is tilt responsive, so we can change the direction and you see how it behaves. And also we have this one. Okay, if I press softer, I get this, and if I press harder, I get a blending with the paper. And as you can see, there is no texture on the background. There is no need, even when the texture improves the result. This process works really well if you need a solid color as a background, as sometimes illustrators need. you can see this is to create the scratches or some kind of vegetation. And then I have this kind of effect, which I love it. This is the spreader. And I will talk about how to create all these different effects, all these different textures. And the last one, it will be a blender. If you need to blend some edges, but don't destroy a lot the texture, you can do something like this. You can realize how flow is important in these brushes. If I use this brush like this, I can see a watery effect, very soft with a bit of texture. And if I increase the flow, I get a more dense effect automatically. No complex changes in the brush, and you can see how you can play. So you can be playing with different levels of flow and achieve more wash or more opaque. As you can see, this brush has a texture, but we can change it easily. So if we go here to the pattern section, we can change whatever we want to get as a texture. For example, this. And we're going to zoom in a bit to get a better view. And as you can see how this texture is projected, but we can of course invert and we get another effect. In watercolor, there is no too much use of erasing technique, but removing water. So I try to emulate this with the same brush, pressing the E key, and you go to the Krita eraser mode, and the brushes are designed to be good erasers too. Filters. Gradient map color mode option has been added by Carl Olson. Also, the memory leaks have been improved. But why are so important the gradient map features? Well, it's a fast way to give our paintings a colored look. Palletized filter has been added by Carl Olson too. It's good for pixel art and dithering your artwork. David Gowers has provided a lot of patterns to play with. Gaussian Highpass filter. Created by Miguel López, this is a filter very used in photography to enhance the edges, contrast, and make details more visible. Very useful. You can find it here in Filter, Edge Detection, Gaussian Highpass. For other filter improvements, read the release notes. Layers. Layers styles can be used for a lot of things, so make them faster is really a good news. There are also more contributions, but I don't want to extend this video too much. Python. More options for coders are always a bless. If you see this, maybe it doesn't tell you too much. Plugins usually help a software to achieve a specific task that can interest different kind of users. If we look, for example, the Blender community, you can see that a lot of things have been implemented as add-ons. Krita has also this capability, and we are already using scripts or plugins like GMeek. Also, with a bit of research, you can find interesting things like Pigment O or Canvas Body. The first one is to have more sliders in Krita to work with, and the second one is to be able to work with Krita in full screen. There are a lot of possibilities thanks to Python coding language, but remember, this is something Krita team cannot control entirely. Test under your own risk is applied here like in other softwares. Painting RGBA brushes. We presented the possibility, we explained what was in development, and now it's here, the RGBA brushes with preserved lightness and advanced features. We are very used to the typical image in black and white to be used as a brush tip. Krita can handle now RGBA images, storing the alpha channel to keep areas transparent, but also keeping the color of the image, the RGB info. That makes possible to use lightness and opacity separately. And the performance is good. No larger effects, no special tricks. Thanks Dmitry Kasakov and Peter Stats and all the Krita artist community for their feedback. Multi-dimension animated brushes. Animated brushes are useful when you want to achieve more organic looks with more variety. In Krita, we use the GIMP image host format to provide that feature. It's quite complicated to understand completely, but it's really easy to create the basic animated brushes using random or incremental, for example. Sometimes it's obvious that we are using animated brushes, sometimes not. And also Krita tells you when a brush tip is animated with this little text here. Right now it's not included to use with the brush editor and the stamp feature, but thanks to Ivan Jossi, we can use export image as, and then we can modify the dialog parameters to achieve the effect we want to get with the layers in the document. Very powerful. Window handling. Painting in a smaller screen sometimes can be frustrating, so now you can detach the canvas and place your image in another monitor. Color handling. Color is one of the most complex things, but thanks to people like Leonardo Segovia, we can have more improvements related to color. Also, Leonardo is working in things related with dynamic procedural textures. Super nice. The Snapshot Docker. Tuzoazu has rewritten the undo system. Krita has undo and redo feature. But when we are painting longer sessions, we would like to have the ability to take a photo of which state the picture is. It's like capturing the moment. And then, after 200 brushstrokes, take another snapshot. There is no way to achieve that with the undo and redo normal feature. Tools. Magnetic selection tool. Selections are really important and Krita is working hard in them too. We have improvements that can help us to go faster with complex selections thanks to Kuntal Mahumder. When we need to follow an edge to use it as selection, we can use the magnetic selection tool. New modes for the gradient tool. Gradient tool can be used to simulate haze to cover faster big areas and even to play with tricks. As you can see here, if I use the contiguous selection tool and click here, it takes a little time to select the square area. As you can see, I have the perfect tones, the solid tones in this layer. So I can go here and select parts of the image using the current layer, or go to the layer and select the entire block. But it takes a bit of time. So in Krita 4.3, this has been improved. Now I can use all the layers, current layer, or the color leveled layers. And this is pretty useful because I have colored this layer as red, okay, using this square. And now I use this as a reference. So I go here and you can see if I go to another layer, but using the reference as a color leveled layers, I can select pretty fast the content I want. For me, it's a bless. We appreciate a lot the visible things, all the fancy features and brushes and effects. But what makes it stronger a program is the invisible part. We don't like the bugs, so let me put you the X-ray glasses to show you one thing. Now you can see all the bugs related with Krita. It's huge, it's a lot of work. So now Krita community, is our time for reporting bugs. That's the key, and your feedback is really appreciated because it helps to improve the software. If you want to contribute the project reporting bugs, please make sure to provide enough info. This is very important. Like this, for example. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Stay safe and take care of your beloved ones. Bye.